You're listening to the John and Heidi Show, now featuring the wit and wisdom of Dan Ferris.
Okay, dudes, let's walk this sucker.
On Sunny 93.3.
It's the John and Heidi Show bonus hour with Dan Ferris. Good Tuesday, Election Tuesday to you, sir.
I know.
It is Election Day.
Are you guys tingling with excitement?
I am.
Here's the thing. I was invited to work the polls today, and I...
You guys normally do that.
We never did until 2020. Then Heidi signed me up, didn't do it herself, signed me up, threw me under the bus. I had so much fun. I signed her up the next time. And then we both went together. And
we do enjoy it this year. We've just got all these. There's just no way this year. But
I wanted to help, and I feel bad saying no, but I got so much. We don't have many nice days left, Dan. And my neighbors will appreciate me getting my yard tidied up. So
yes, they will.
All right. Well, the big thing's on the ballot, of course. In case you know, if you headed to the polls, when they open at 7, 8, whatever. I don't know. I'm within walking distance of my polling place.
Oh, are you really? Nice.
Which is nice. Oh yeah. Yeah. It's just a couple blocks. So
yeah,
I drive. So I'm not crazy. But me too. The big ballot issues apparently are marijuana and bacon.
Oh yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, that's so, right. The slaughterhouse.
You want more bacon, less
Which
bacon?
Is weird.
Do you want more dope or less dope?
They don't use the word slaughterhouse anywhere else, but they're using it for this thing.
Oh,
of course,
John.
It's almost like they want it to sound negative.
John, it's called marketing, man.
I know.
Figure it out.
That's right.
Whatever. It's going to be what it's going to be. But do your civic duty and.
Today's the day.
Darn it, vote as many times as you can.
Once. It's important.
Who's having birthdays today? I just love her. She is such a disaster. She just absolutely, in fact, ended up in the best film franchise ever. And, of course, I'm talking about the Sharknado.
Oh, yeah.
Franchise, of which there are 6 and hoping for a 7th any day now. Tara Reid.
Oh, yeah.
I like Tara Reid.
She plays April Wexler in the Sharknado series.
I feel bad. I've only seen part of one Sharknado.
That's it?
I've only seen part of
John.
One.
Oh, John.
I know.
You
I really
don't
need to
know
make
what
time.
You're missing.
You know, the cameos are hilarious.
They are.
Well, maybe we'll have a Sharknado marathon sometime, Dan.
Terry is 47 today.
Nice. Okay.
And does not return my calls.
I think I'm that same age.
Yeah, you are.
Am I? Yeah. So she and I are pretty close in age.
Uh-huh. Yeah, we're nowhere near close in age.
My birthday's just a few weeks from now, so she's just a tiny bit older.
Hey, Chef Extraordinaire, TV personality. The guy should be on the $20 bill. Gordon Ramsay is 56 today.
That guy's hilarious.
You remember that episode where he yelled at somebody?
That one time.
Every single episode.
Remember that time? And this guy, he was huge 70s and 80s teen idol, man. A heartthrob, Leif Garrett.
Oh, yeah.
What's
he up to now?
I have no idea. Huh. Leif Per Nervik.
His real name is that?
Is his name. His middle name is spelled P-E-R, Per. Yeah, Per, then Nervik. He is 61 today.
Nice.
You know, he had almost a dozen Hot 100 top 20 hits.
Oh, yeah.
Believe it or not, a lot of them were like remakes, like Fun, Fun, Fun by the Beach Boys.
Right.
Oh, yeah. But he had his own stuff, and including Are You Satisfied? I was, and my personal favorite, the 78 classic, a top 10 hit, I Was Made for Dancing.
Oh, yeah, I remember that.
Would you like a little dramatic
Yes,
reading?
We would.
Leif Garrett, I Was Made for Dancing. I've got to find out if you're feeling it, too. It's hard to tell, so here's what I do. When every time I want more, I'll take you out on the floor. I was made for dancing all night long. Yeah, I was made for dancing all night long. Yeah. Garrett this
I think
morning.
We got to find a place
poetry.
Where we can save
it's
these
poetry.
Dramatic readings so people can download them as ringtones.
I should put out an album.
There should be an album.
That's all there is to it.
Yeah.
A little taste of history, things that formed this great nation and the world in which we live and breathe. It was this. I found this hard to believe, and so I researched it, and it's totally true. 1972, HBO, which is what we call home box office, is the official name.
From 72?
It launched in 1972.
Why did I think it was like 80?
Yeah, I was thinking that was 80s.
Isn't that weird?
Too.
Apparently the first 8 years, they didn't do much to impress me.
It is, in fact, the oldest paid TV channel.
Wow. I had no idea.
In the country. The very first thing they aired, the very first film, the very first movie.
Yeah.
Little thing
Porky's.
Called, Porky.
No, that was on every other movie in the 80s.
This was one of the Fast and Furious movies. Sometimes a Great Notion, starring Paul Newman and Henry Fonda.
Okay.
Yeah, but 1972?
I've never heard of that.
There were some great
one.
Films. When I was a kid, we had an HBO at our house. And there were some great films on there that you don't see anywhere else. Kidco was my favorite. I love that movie.
The Heavenly Kid was on there all the time.
Good stuff, Dan. Good stuff.
Thanks. Yeah, and it is November, of course. November given over to our veterans, our military.
Yeah. Yes.
Day coming up. Fact, Friday. Friday's a huge day. This is a cool little story. It was this day in 1950. U.S. aircraft shoots down a North Korean jet. North Korea, it's bad Korea, of course. During the Korean War.
Bad Korea.
What was the big deal?
What was the big deal?
That would be the very first jet-to-jet dogfight in history.
Really?
Really?
Yeah. United States 1, North Korea 0.
Huh.
Nice.
There were a lot of airplane to airplane, but that was the first jet-to-jet.
First jet-to-jet.
Wow.
Yeah.
Nice.
And in 1956, I will still watch this film every time I trip over it. 1956, Cecil B. DeMille's biblical drama, The Ten Commandments.
Oh, yeah. That's right.
Premieres.
Dan's told me about how much he likes this.
Starring Charlton Heston as Moses, Yul Brynner as bad pharaoh guy Ramses, but my favorite miscast, Edward G. Robinson is in this thing. And up to then, he's a big gangster movie guy.
Yeah,
always plays a gangster. Edward G. Robinson. Yeah, so where's your Messiah now? Huh? Yeah, see? Not such a tough guy now, is he?
Let's try to get him without that.
Yeah.
Do some acting this time.
Yeah, where's your Messiah now, tough guy? Yeah, see? So there you go. I know.
So funny.
You know, we all know, and we just bounce forward here.
We're going to do it. It is the John and Heidi Show Bonus Hour with Dan Ferris.
In good times and not so good times, it's a good idea to be responsible when it comes to spending. At BetterCreditCards.com, we're excited to see our friends like you get a better credit card to fit your needs. Some people like cards with the lowest possible interest rate. Others like cards with no annual fee. And some people like cards with points and perks to take advantage of all the extras available. Whatever you're looking for, we hope you find it at BetterCreditCards.com. Give yourself a little credit. BetterCreditCards.com.
We have a guest joining us today, Stacey Andernacht, and she is with Feeding South Dakota, and they've got something special coming up next Saturday, the 19th, and it's for Thanksgiving. Stacey, tell me a little bit about what's coming up next Saturday.
Yeah, absolutely. Thanks for having me today. So, we here in Sioux Falls and across South Dakota, we have so many families that just aren't sure how they're going to put a meal on their table this Thanksgiving. And so we are offering a Thanksgiving meal giveaway on Saturday the 19th as an opportunity for those families to come and pick up the groceries for a traditional Thanksgiving meal.
And this is a wonderful thing that you guys do. Feeding South Dakota has been around a long time, and you feed people year-round. So this is not just something at Thanksgiving. Need knows no season. This is all the time, but I love that you're doing this. What is going to be involved in this Thanksgiving meal?
Yeah, so you're absolutely right. Every month, we have mobile food distributions where families come and get food from us as well. And this Thanksgiving meal giveaway is in addition to our November distribution. So those individuals who are coming to get food from us through the month of November can also come get these groceries. And it's everything you need. It's the turkey, the stuffing, the potatoes and gravy, some cranberry sauce, green beans, fresh carrots, as well as some croissants and a dessert. So that everything can be put on that table and that nice holiday meal can be served.
Now, with prices of many things going up, I'm assuming you guys probably have more of a need this year, more people that have a need. Is there a way, if somebody's listening that's going, man, I've never done this before, but boy, this I probably do need some help. How do they get in touch with you? How does this whole program work?
Sure. Yeah, that's a really great question. And you're right. We are seeing just a continued increase in people using our program. So making people aware of how to access that is ideal. The Thanksgiving meal giveaway itself, there's no need to sign up, register, anything like that. The giveaway begins at 8 a.m. at the fairgrounds in Sioux Falls. So we just ask folks to come out. It's between 8 to 10 a.m. or until we run out of the meals. We'll have 1,500 meals that we're giving away that day. So you can just come on out to the fairgrounds, enter from Madison Street, and line up that way. As far as our monthly mobile distributions, we have several of them across the state. And if you go to our website, feedingsouthdakota.org, you can find a list of all of the communities. There's 94 total communities, as well as the dates and location and time of those monthly distributions.
Very nice. And again, Feeding South Dakota is an amazing organization. If somebody listening is saying, you know, I love what you guys do, you're a nonprofit. If they want to contribute to help make this mm-hmm. happen, how do they give to Feeding South Dakota?
Yeah, you know, and we are feeling the impacts of inflation here at Feeding South Dakota as well. You know, where it's the donated food is down, as well as the cost to acquire food is up for us. In addition to that increase in people we're serving. So in order to continue this critical work that we're doing, donations are really a great way to support us. And you can do that through our website, again, at feedingsouthdakota.org. And actually, right now, thanks to Greg and Pam Sands of Sands Wall Systems, every dollar that's donated is going to be matched. And that's
nice.
Really an incredible way to stretch, to stretch your dollar. So the Thanksgiving meals, $25 provides a meal for one family. But when you give a gift between now and December 24th, we're going to double that, and two families will get that meal. So it's a really good time to give a donation, and every dollar helps.
That is wonderful. I think that's very, very cool. Stacey, thank you for your time today. I appreciate it. And thank you so much for doing what you guys do.
Yeah, thanks for having me. And we just really appreciate you sharing out all the great things that we have going on here.
Again, Feeding South Dakota. And if you would like to get more information, their website, feedingsouthdakota.org. Don't forget, next Saturday, the 19th of September, that is when they're doing the Thanksgiving food giveaway. If you'd like to get more details on that, again, feedingsouthdakota.org.
How much do you pay for your wireless phone? Some people spend hundreds of dollars every month for their family. That's crazy! Mint Mobile offers premium wireless for just $15 a month. Not 50, 15, 1-5. Yeah, $15 a month for premium wireless. It's time for a Mintervention from Mint Mobile. You can keep your same phone number. You may even be able to keep your same phone. Find out now at Mintervention.com. Learn more and sign up today at Mintervention.com. Premium wireless for just $15 a month at Mintervention.com. That's Mintervention.com.
And now stuff Dan finds interesting.
It is time for stuff Dan finds interesting. Dan, what do you find interesting on this Election Day Tuesday?
Well, yeah, and again, like we need a reminder, it is Election Day. There was some hubbubbery recently.
Oh, about what?
Some hubbubbery with the Kristi Noem campaign in Chamberlain. She's been running all over.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, she's showing up everywhere, which is pretty crazy. As far as I can tell, she's a shoe-in. She's going to win. But, man, she's just out there. She's dropping by high school sporting events and little cafes and you name it.
Her back surgery, she must be all healed up. So I'm glad to hear that. That's good.
I would do anything to make sure she's okay.
I would do anything.
I'm here for you. I had coffee with her in Hartford.
Yes, you did. And you were both wearing black.
We were. And I got to ask her a question. I did. I raised my hand, and he said, yes. And I said, so how you doing?
Nice. And Dan, we're all wondering, how was she doing?
She's doing
I would have paid you to do that. That would have been hilarious.
So she drops by Chamberlain, South Dakota, so a cafe, and one of the cooks who worked there says he was forced into a photo.
Which I've never seen that for a second.
With
but,
her.
Okay.
And as a little rebel yell down to the side, he flipped the bird.
Yeah, he raised the one-finger salute.
Yeah. The guy's name is Stephen Monto. Monto?
He has the right to do that.
It's French. Became kind of an internet sensation in South Dakota. He has been fired.
Yeah. And the boss has the right to do that.
Lost his job. Well, that's what I was going to ask.
They both have the freedom to do what they did to do.
You know, would you, if you owned that business, would you have fired him, John?
Yes.
And the thing is, I'll put myself in those shoes because I own this business with my beautiful bride, Heidi. And if somebody were to do that while they were working here, whether it was somebody I agree with or even if it was somebody I disagree with, if they were disrespectful like that, enough so that it was going to cause issues nationwide, I would say,
I'm sorry.
Not when you're on the clock,
you.
Dude. Yep. Sorry. So, Dan, we got to have a talk. just kidding.
Well, yeah, I think you need to know the details. I mean, he says he was forced into it. Well, not really. She was getting ready to leave. Somebody said, whatever, how about a picture? And he happened to be standing there. And she said, hey, let's take a picture. He could have said, no, thanks.
Yep.
Yeah.
But yep. Yeah.
I've been around that exact scenario. I've never once seen anybody force anybody to be in a photo.
No.
Ever, ever, never, ever, once. Not even once.
He's smiling big in the picture.
Oh, yeah, because he's being, well, it's not professional.
No.
Well, and no, he definitely
again, he had
been fired.
He had the right to do it, and I stand up for his right to do it.
Well, here's
but
the
boss had their right to do that, too.
The other side of that. Mondo, who's 30 years of age, set up a GoFundMe page.
I saw that.
And it's already
people
raised.
Spoken.
It's almost raised $7,000.
Yeah, I think they shut it down now, but he's done very well with it.
Yep. He said, thank you all who have donated and support these past few days. I do work for another place of employment full time now. This well, good for you.
Yeah, okay. Good for him.
I just thought that was kind of an interesting story.
And there are people who've come down on both sides of that real hard, by the way. Real hard.
Well,
on both sides
that's what
this.
Happens. But. Yeah. But when it's your business, no, I do believe that the business owner did the right thing there because that's totally inappropriate.
Well, and again, I'm not saying based on whose side or what I agree with, but what's right and what's wrong.
Yeah.
If he had done that to somebody on the other side, I think that would still be the right answer.
No, so. I agree.
So again, there you go. Hey, Dan, thanks for talking politics. I never talk politics.
I wasn't talking no. politics.
Mm-hmm. No, I agree with mm-hmm. no, it was
that wasn't
all good.
My point, talking politics at all.
It was just okay. a situation.
Wonder who he's voting for.
Good Maybe question. We could do an interview.
Yeah, I'll give him a call.
Find out.
I'll give him a call. See what's going on. I just found that interesting. It's a bizarre little deal.
I also found it interesting. Heidi, did you?
I did find
three
it interesting.
Three out of three, Dan.
Hey.
That's why we're for
good
this.
Day's work.
Yeah. Stuff. All Dan right. finds interesting. Thanks yeah. for listening to the John and Heidi Show Bonus Hour with Dan Ferris.
In good times and not so good times, it's a good idea to be responsible when it comes to spending. At BetterCreditCards.com, we're excited to see our friends like you get a better credit card to fit your needs. Some people like cards with the lowest possible interest rate. Others like cards with no annual fee. And some people like cards with points and perks to take advantage of all the extras available. Whatever you're looking for, we hope you find it at BetterCreditCards.com. Give yourself a little credit. BetterCreditCards.com.
Here's your Market Beat Minute for Tuesday, November 8th, 2022. The major indices jumped more than 1% as investors looked to the midterm elections and changes they may bring. By the end of the day today, certainly by opening of trading Wednesday, the market will know if Republicans have taken control of Capitol Hill or if the Democrats and Biden agenda have won out. Either way, the news will move markets Wednesday and could impact the market's direction well into 2023. The biggest risk for the week, however, is the CPI reading, which is due out Thursday. The consumer-level inflation is expected to remain hot on all levels, but may show some signs of slowing in the year-over-year comparisons, if not enough to alter the Fed's stance on interest rates. The question that needs to be answered, however, is if the FOMC will hike by another 75 basis points in December, or if this data will give them the room to start slowing the pace of interest rate increases. You can get the inside track from Wall Street's brightest minds delivered directly to your inbox every day at marketbeatminute.com.